This afternoon at 4, Interstate 80 is back open following a Tesla semi-truck crash and fire yesterday after toxic concerns of toxic fumes brought drivers to a stop. It took crews hours to fully extinguish the truck's batteries, delaying thousands of drivers. Thanks for joining us here for Fox 40 News at 4. I'm Riley Carroll. Fox 40's Chloe Curtis breaks down what makes extinguishing fires like this so challenging.
CAL FIRE says it responds to about 30 working commercial vehicle fires each year between the Auburn and Truckee area, but says yesterday's semi-truck crash was the first electric vehicle fire this year.
CAL FIRE says the difference it saw yesterday was the battery in the Tesla semi-truck was under what's called thermal runaway, which caused a chemical chain reaction. It's a process that doesn't stop until the energy in the battery is spent, and the battery used yesterday is much larger than a typical Tesla.
Because the size of the battery packs, which are typically five times the size of like a typical sedan EV vehicle you would see, there's a lot more energy stored within those.
Battery fires are chemical in nature, so crews have to wait for the battery to cool down enough before they can fully extinguish it with water. Now, given the growing popularity of electric vehicles, several agencies, including CAL FIRE, have gone through training specifically for electric vehicle fires.
Hundreds of semi-trucks that travel this stretch daily had to be diverted yesterday, some of them taking well over 10 hours to get back on the road. In Nyack, covering local news that matters, Chloe Curtis, Fox 40 News.